All right, issues galore. First, okay, so you did all the big shows downstairs.
Yeah.
And were they asked like stupid questions? Were the questions just ridiculous and non sequiturs about dumb stuff? Yes, come
yes,
on, please.
Yes, they were.
Like what? Go
it's
on.
All the same spill, questions. Spill. I'm going to let you decide that.
All right.
Nice taste in footwear.
Do you like
way.
It? Are you in the same thing? Here's the thing.
The New Balance.
How every person in the world over 35, every man,
yeah,
which I imagine encompasses both of us, wears these New Balances.
Is that really?
It's true. It's like
so comfortable.
It's like a rite of passage.
It's like wearing glue.
It is.
Like, yeah.
And then how often do you replenish?
Too often.
Really?
I like to go by the New Balance story.
Every time?
Every year or so.
See? Yeah, me too. Because then the new ones feel so much better than the old ones.
Yeah, yeah. It's true.
This might get us each a bunch of free New Balance. 9.5. What about you?
12.
12?
Yeah.
Impressive.
Thank you.
Very good. Well done. All right, I've got problems galore. Number one, the gal outside thought I was Gino from Minneapolis.
How dare they?
What is the deal with that?
I know. Do you want to talk about the movie at all?
Not really.
Me neither.
Okay, I didn't think so.
Good.
I figured you were tired of
good.
That.
Good, yeah, no.
Okay. And then the next thing, what I was going to ask you is, are you concerned that Paul Rudd is in every movie?
Paul Rudd is in it's crazy because 2010, Paul Rudd is literally in every single film that's coming out. It doesn't matter what the next Bond.
Right.
Everything.
And you're contributing to that even here.
Well, yeah, yes, this is a Paul Rudd film. That's what I aspire to.
How did he elbow his way into this?
You know, I don't know, man. He's doing great with that.
And is that bad for you?
No, he's funny. He always makes me laugh. Yeah.
All right, to vaguely talk about the movie, because I guess
okay.
Because they bought the lunch, if nothing else.
Yes.
You're quite good in it.
Thank you.
I really think so. And for some reason, I would envision, and I don't know you, and I don't know why I would say
okay.
this, but in fourth grade, and ninth grade, and 11th grade, you like were that guy.
You think I was an evil alien warlord in the ninth grade?
Or aspired to be.
Yeah, I actually was. I attempted world domination from my junior high, Kellogg Junior High, in North Suburban Seattle.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it didn't work out so well, but it was a lot of fun. Oh yeah, nanotechnology. Oh, those are the days.
And did you have that? I think we all envision because it would seem to me if I were to imagine myself as a space character, you know. But I think that you would think you would look like.
I grew up watching science fiction. I mean, I loved that stuff. You know, I thrived on that. So when they called me about, hey, do you want to play an evil alien warlord intent on world destruction? I was like, sure.
Did you practice the laugh?
I didn't have to. I was born with an evil laugh. I think it was my first words. I was came out of the womb and I was like.
And then is there a particular voice one puts on for this?
Yeah, you kind of have a long process of creating the voice and finding the voice. So, you know, I had some ideas upon seeing it and knowing the kind of tone that they were going for, and they helped me shape it, and it was a blast.
So can you snap into it now if I were to ask you to talk like him?
I think I could, yeah. What do you want me to say?
Whatever you could say. You could say, the big interview with Rainn Wilson is coming up live after 7 if you want. That would be...
The big interview with Rainn Wilson is coming up after 7 or something like that.
We will manipulate that ad nauseum.
Oh, good.
Very good. Nice to see you, Rainn.
Okay.
Thanks so much. Thank you.
Nice talking to you. Say hi to your wife and daughter.
I will.